Today we have brought you the latest Tesla news. Panasonic selects Kansas as site of its North American 4680 plant, reports suggest. Tesla battery supplier Panasonic aims for 20% cell density improvement by 2030. NHTSA won't allow EVs to have unlimited or custom pedestrian alert sounds. And Tesla looks to sell good quality early Model Y units from Giga Berlin, reports suggest. Let's get into all the details. So let's get started. Tesla battery supplier Panasonic has reportedly decided to build its next battery plant in Kansas, USA. The facility is expected to provide high-capacity 4680 battery cells to American electric vehicle manufacturer Tesla. Reports of Panasonic's upcoming United States plant have been around for several months now. Back in March, the Nippon Hoso Kaikai, NHK, or the Japan Broadcasting Corporation, published a report stating that Panasonic had shortlisted Kansas and Oklahoma as potential sites for its new battery factory. As noted in a recent Nikkei Asia report, Panasonic opted for Kansas due to a variety of factors, such as its proximity to Tesla's Gigafactory Texas facility and some favorable tax deals. The Japanese company is reportedly expecting to invest several billion dollars in its Kansas battery plant. Panasonic has adopted a number of aggressive targets for its battery production activities. Panasonic reportedly aims to triple or even quadruple its EV battery production capacity by fiscal 2028 from its current 50 gigawatt hour per year. If successful, Panasonic's capacity could reach 150 to 200 gigawatt hour by fiscal 2028. Panasonic will likely be busy in the near future. The company reportedly plans to install two production lines at its battery component facility in Wakayama Prefecture in Japan in fiscal 2023. The facility could then begin to produce 4680 cells for Tesla. The investment is expected to cost about $580 million. Tesla's 4680 battery cells are expected to carry the electric vehicle maker's lineup over the coming years. With vehicles like the Cybertruck and the Semi entering production next year, Tesla would need to secure a strong supply of 4680 cells, even if it needs to tap into numerous sources to do so. These include Panasonic and LG Energy Solution, as well as the electric car maker's own battery production efforts. Moving to the next update, Tesla battery supplier Panasonic aims for 20% cell density improvement by 2030. Longtime Tesla battery supplier Panasonic is working on new innovations that could increase its cells density by 20% by 2030. If achieved, the improvements could boost the driving range of electric vehicles, even if the cars use the same battery packs they are equipped with today. In the case of the Tesla Model Y, the improved energy density could result in the vehicle getting an extra 62 miles of range without changing its battery size. More energy-dense batteries could also allow manufacturers to design and produce electric cars that are lighter and more spacious, while still offering long range. Panasonic's battery density targets were related to Reuters by the company's chief technology officer, Shichiro Watanabe, during an interview. According to Watanabe, Panasonic is looking to achieve its battery density gains through the use of new additives that would allow individual cells to run at a higher voltage without damaging performance. The race among battery makers has been to come up with more potent and effective additives, the Panasonic CTO said. A 20% increase in energy density could translate to an energy density of 900 watt-hours per liter, a substantial improvement over Panasonic's most advanced cells today, which feature 750 watt-hours per liter. Watanabe mentioned that Panasonic is planning on achieving its battery density gains over several years, though he did not mention when the improved cells would begin their rollout. Panasonic is extremely busy with its battery supply deal with Tesla, with the Japanese company expected to start the mass production of the American electric car maker's 4680 batteries during the financial year starting April 2023. Panasonic is also reportedly reviewing sites for new battery production activities in the United States. So far, A Panasonic spokesperson has declined to provide a comment on whether the company's new battery technologies would be incorporated in Tesla's 2170 or 4680 cells. Tesla, for its part, has also remained silent about the matter. Moving to the next update, NHTSA won't allow EVs to have unlimited or custom pedestrian alert sounds. The National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, NHTSA, stated recently that it will not allow electric vehicles to have an unlimited amount of custom sounds that could be used as pedestrian alert tones. In 2019, the NHTSA passed FMVSS number 141, which required all hybrid and electric vehicles to have a noisemaker installed to alert pedestrians nearby that a car was coming. Due to their lack of a combustion engine, electric and hybrid vehicles make minimal noise, making them hazards to pedestrians, especially the blind, who cannot necessarily hear or see a vehicle approaching. Tesla began installing noisemakers on the Model 3 initially, with the first builds showing a speaker system installed just under the frunk. Other manufacturers also followed suit, with all vehicles fitting this description required to install the noisemaker by September 1, 2020, 1 year after FMVSS number 141 was officially put in effect. Tesla was willing to allow owners to download their own sounds and use them in alignment with the new regulation. After all, there were no concrete guidelines set by the NHTSA that outlined what sounds were considered acceptable, which gave Tesla permission on a technicality to allow owners to have their freedom. The Alliance of Automobile Manufacturers and Global Automakers submitted a joint petition to the NHTSA 2 years before the FMVSS number 141 took effect. The proposal, according to Automotive News, said that car makers could install a number of compliant sounds in electric vehicles that would eventually hit the market. The NHTSA, however, decided this week that it would not allow automakers to let drivers use any sounds as a pedestrian noisemaker, even ones deemed compliant. The alliance between the Alliance of Automobile Manufacturers and Global Automakers drafted a joint letter with the National Federation of the Blind, who supported the idea that if drivers are not satisfied with their car's pedestrian alert sound, they should be able to disable it completely if there is no option to change it. Moving to the last update, Tesla looks to sell good quality early Model Y units from Giga Berlin, reports suggest. Tesla Gigafactory Berlin has started its planned factory upgrades, but the electric vehicle maker seems to have a plan to keep its vehicle delivery teams busy for the time being. As per local reports from German media, Tesla is reportedly looking to sell some units from its early Model Y production to customers. Prior to Tesla receiving its final approval to start vehicle production in Giga Berlin, the company was allowed to produce its first batch of vehicles under a preliminary permit. First it was 250 vehicles, but later permissions allowed Tesla to manufacture 2,000 more Model Ys at Gigafactory Berlin. These vehicles were initially reported to be unavailable for purchase. Recent documents retrieved by Markische Dursitting have revealed that Tesla has only discarded about 100 of these pre-production Model Ys that were made in its Grünheide factory. The vast majority of the early production vehicles would be used for internal purposes and various test purposes. In the documents, Tesla also suggests that early Model Y production units with good quality could be sold to end consumers. Tesla noted in its letter that based on planned tests, good quality early Model Y units could continue to be used without major restrictions. This suggests that the vehicles are ready for consumers and their quality is on par with the Model Ys produced at Giga Berlin after Tesla was able to secure its final approval to begin vehicle production in the facility. Tesla's document retrieved by the German media is heavily redacted, so the details of what exactly happened to the company's early production Model Y units could not be determined as of now. However, Tesla may have a point with its assertion that some of its early production Model Ys from Giga Berlin, especially those that were produced in the weeks leading up to the plan's final approval, may indeed be good enough for consumers. Gigafactory Berlin's upgrades are expected to be completed around July 2022, and with it, the facility should be able to produce Model Ys at a quicker rate. Tesla expects Gigafactory Berlin to be capable of producing 500,000 vehicles per year, a notable goal, considering the demand for the all-electric crossover in the region. That's it for now. So what are your thoughts about this? Let us know in the comments. Stay tuned at the Electric Arena for all the latest Tesla and electric vehicle news.